What are your updates,
Jimmy?
Yeah.
Jimmy?
Yes.
What are you doing there?
Oh, hey, reader. What's up? Just my Argan treatment, my daily treatment for my hair with my fantastical Argan oil.
Thank you, CJ, for challenging me with Argan oil. I looked it up, I went right to the internet, and the one thing I noticed is that it's used predominantly in hair care products, right? And I didn't even know it was edible. And it's used a lot in Moroccan cuisines. It's from the Argan nut, whatever tree. I looked at buying the actual Argan nuts, and they were like insanely expensive, like $80 a pound, so we nixed that. Then I called Roderick at Rare Tea, because I figured if anybody would know about this kind of product, it would be him, because he also has luscious hair as well. He sent me this bottle, and it's this Argan oil. It tastes like dried Sicilian cured olives. Okay, so imagine like that meaty fruitiness you get without like the salinity, but then like this weird like, people say that it has like an almondy flavor. I think it kind of reminds me of like plastic and cardboard, but there's this one traditional thing I saw called amlu, and it's like this dip almost of like super hard roasted almonds with tons of honey, and it's like a sweet like spread, and they use the argan oil to kind of like emulsify into it.
When I researched the amlu, that almond paste that's used in Moroccan cooking, it was funny because we currently make something that's similar. We toast off pumpkin seeds really hard in a pan with olive oil, then we add in garlic and burnt honey, and it kind of makes this paste that we blend silky smooth, and we use it as this like almost like seed butter to dress cucumbers that we char and pack with lime juice, and that's an accompaniment to the octopus that we currently serve. So it felt like it was almost like it was destined, it was meant to be. Now this is a $90 bottle of argan oil that we're going to frivolously use as poaching liquid for a delicate piece of Icelandic cod.
We're just gonna go all out to excess.
Here, smell that. It smells like olives and like hot, like, it doesn't smell like olive oil. It smells like kind of funky blue cheese, like Limburger. So I like to season pretty heavily when I'm gonna poach like this, because there's a good chance that a lot of that salt won't actually stick to the fish. We basically didn't have spring, but we still had some spring ingredients popping up. A couple of things that I thought would be really nice is to go off this delicate cod with this really rich, toasty, nutty flavored pumpkin seed that's similar to the amlu. And then the poached cod, I felt like a lot of very acidic, sharp, under-ripened green things would be a really nice kind of complexity to go off of. So just a couple of green almonds just to give crunch. This is the actual almond in its youngest stage. We took some green strawberries that are super young, so basically under-ripened. To play off that tartness, we took a little bit of sweet muscat vinegar, packed them with a little bit of salt, so almost 2% salt, and then just packed them to kind of get really nice and intense. I was thinking about rhubarb, so we'll see if we use it.
Is it raw?
This is just raw. Fish will cook super, super delicately, super slow, probably about 15 minutes, just to barely cook it through. A little spigarello, beautiful like brassica flavor, so it's really like crunchy, great texture. So we're gonna do some nice, beautiful, fresh dill. One thing I like to do is take it out, just give it one of these to kind of get all of the fronds kind of excited and woken up almost.
We've got all of our kids in the pool, to say the least.
What I wanna do is season it with a little argan oil. As if we didn't have enough on the cod. It looks beautiful though. It's just turning like, you know, cake, not overcooked. So we'll put down our pumpkin seed amlu, which is that Moroccan style dish. I don't want to drain too much of that argan oil off because it's super delicious. I want everybody to really get the full effect. So here's our cod, and right down on top. A salad of rhubarb. Some marinated green strawberries, some green almonds, beautiful oxalises, some dill. Looks like a heart for my love for argan oil. And then some these nice little brassicas over the top. I'm gonna try just the fish first and just see if it's imparted. First thing you taste is like that argan oil. It's interesting.
We all know what interesting means in a restaurant.
Conceptually, like, it makes sense, right? Like seeds, almonds, fruit, that traditional, you know, Moroccan dish, amlu, that it's really used for. But I'm just not too crazy about it. It's just like that overpowering taste of that argan oil. hard to cover, I guess you would say. So,
Argan, the oil of your locks.
Yeah. He brings and works with some of the best fish in the city. And I felt like it would be a perfect opportunity to tell Mark Helyar that he has to cook with not just tuna, but canned tuna. Bumblebee.